So, let's go and try this again. Welcome back to American Truck Simulator. My name is Moose78. Hopefully you guys are doing well today, by the way. We are down here in Flagstaff, Arizona, and the SES Peterbilt 389. Getting ready to grab a big old 53-foot container, run down to... Where were we going? We are going down here to Yuma. Probably a quick stream, like I said, probably a quick stream today. Run a little bit behind. But I want to stream today, tomorrow, and Wednesday. Ideally, I want to do it like from around 10 to 1 each day. See how everything goes, though. We're good to go there. Go out here and see what kind of damage I can cause today. That's recording, that's streaming. All right, we're good. How's the stream looking, Bear? Looking okay, nice and smooth. No buffering, no stuttering, anything like that. Changed out my weather mod, went to, as you probably saw there at the start, the latest edition of the S-Gate weather mod. I had been using a realistic weather mod from the Steam Workshop, but the last couple updates, I didn't like it. It was getting to look too dark. And even with the HDR on, it was just like real dark, so. Whoa. Game about lagged out on me there. Z Freight Market. There we go. Get our trailer. Gotta get used to driving with the big old hood out there again. Been driving the Pinnacle and the 680. Been one of these big old large cars for a while. There's our trailer over there. We go. I don't know, it's like pulling these containers from time to time. Is it trying to rain? Why, yes it is. A little bit different. Hardly ever rains in my game. So I got the probability turned down pretty low. I'll give it a minute, see if it picks up any before I turn my lights or wipers on. Imagine the game's probably going to come out of the beta state pretty soon. Seems like the first few days of the beta, they updated, fixed quite a bit of stuff. But they've not updated for a couple days, so I'd imagine they pretty much got it where they want it. Traffic's pretty light. Take it. Looks like the weather is picking up just a little bit, so. That's usually a crapshoot as to whether your mods are going to work or not. Luckily, I didn't have to really deactivate a whole lot of mods, pretty much just the map mods. Other than that, everything worked pretty much without a hitch. Luckily. Not always, there we go. Not always the case, though. The Yuma. I haven't got it installed yet, but I got an updated copy of the East Genesis end up with the lift axle activated, so that's pretty cool. I think, I gotta go back and double check, but I think all that is to activate the lift axle option on the trailer is just, I think you just have to add a line to the definition, but don't quote me on that because I'm not 100% sure, but I thought that's all it was. I don't know, I've not touched a Z-Modeler or Blender in forever. Well, I've never really touched Blender, I still need to learn that, but I haven't touched a Z-Mod for quite a while. ATS since that last live stream. It's been about a week and a half. Always good to get back in it though. Looks like the weather's gonna break here for us. Yeah, I like this weather mod a lot better than the last versions of the realistic weather mod by Frank 64. be nice to see them go back to kind of some of the older versions, kind of get to look like that again. Using the N14 Select Plus 610 horsepower chip engine in this today, by the way. Probably my favorite sound by Creech Bomb so far. And everything is just so spot on with this. Sounds really good. Jake sounds good. The horns sound good. Seen any updates on that for a while. I don't know if they're just waiting until 1.6 goes live, which would kind of make sense. Because I'd hate if I was making a map mod or anything like that, I'd hate to update it for the beta, just to have to go back and update it, numerous times throughout the course of the beta. That was kind of the bad thing about MHA. They had just got it, within a couple weeks, something like that. Released their 1.5 version, and then shortly after that, 1.6 beta goes live. So it is what it is, though. And I keep checking the blog periodically, and not really seeing any major updates since 1.6 update. I'm just still curious as to what the heck is going on with the trucks. And they continually say that, it has to do with licensing issues, but I would have thought in the last year they would have been able to iron a lot of that stuff out. Laytonville to the vanilla map or Project West. What's going on, Wild Savage? How you doing today? Okay, adding Project West. That'd be nice if Project West starts to add more stuff than just Southern California and just California in general. Like if they start to add stuff to Arizona and Nevada, that would be awesome. I'm not doing too bad for a Monday. Running a little bit behind, so the stream started a little bit late, but we're here trucking on down to Yuma, Arizona. Take a look at the truck here real quick. Drive off the road. There we go. SES 389. That's always a good thing, no school. Okay, no, I honestly haven't paid too much attention to Project West, but it sounds like I kind of need to. If that's the case, I will definitely start checking that out and using that. Of course, once we get out of the open beta state. And hopefully here before too much longer we get into Mexico. At least some updates on it. Some kind of signs, I mean something, you know, something that flashes on your GPS. I know that wouldn't be extremely realistic if it flashed up on your GPS, but, you know, just some kind of signage or something saying, hey, and, you know, 2 miles, there's a reduced, you know, speed zone or lane ends. Be kind of cool. And if that's going to be a mod that they're going to, you know, pretty actively support, then yeah, I'm all about checking that out. Be nice if it was compatible with MHA. But I don't think that's going to be the case just with some of the stuff they already have in there. Maybe NHA can kind of make theirs a little bit compatible with Project West, but I doubt it. See where we're at. Eh, we're just about down to Yuma. Just about down there. So I'll probably use this today, then tomorrow. Not sure what I'm going to use tomorrow. Might break out the Pinnacle. Been wanting to use that. Still need to get my review done on that. Have not gotten around to that. Was going to do it last week, but we kind of got away from me there, and so maybe I'll try to get that done later on this week. Might try to knock that out one morning before the stream or something. I don't want to use that. There was something else I was going to use too. Got an FLD that I might use. know, maybe I'll just have to make the switch to Project West. Kind of mix it up and freshen it up a little bit. So I've been using MHA for quite a while. Hopefully, everything goes according to plan this week, and I can get some, you know, like I said, I want to stream today, tomorrow, and Wednesday. Then I got some stuff going on Thursday and Friday, but I want to get enough content built up in the next 3 days to where I can actually sit down and get some modding done. We're close enough, shouldn't have to worry about rest. We got like 2 hours, so right about the time we get to Yuma, be about time for a rest. Or maybe sooner. But I got some stuff that I want to do to this. A couple little things I want to do to the W900. Minor things, and of course I want to get the 680 done one of these days. I haven't touched that in quite a while. I want to get that done. It's kind of up in the air what I want to do with it, though. If I want to continue the project in Z-Modeler, or if I want to kind of start from scratch over in Blender. I don't know. It would probably make sense just to finish it up in Z-Modeler, since I'm about halfway done with what I want to do. But it's a ways from being released. There's some stuff I want to do to it. Want to give it to a couple friends in over at American Pride Modding Group. Gotta let them play with it a little bit and see what they can add to it. Be nice if someone can make a flat top version for it. Say that mod, that just pretty much like fix some stuff that's like already been fixed, doesn't it? What are we doing here, people? Fuel, so I ain't gonna worry about going down there. Need to check something here real quick. There we go. There we go. Didn't realize the audio was playing on my computer for the stream. Where I want to run to from Yuma. I want to get into California a little bit, or if I want to run up into northern Arizona and eventually get up into Nevada. Or run north up into California and get into Nevada that way. stop it. You got freight to deliver. We ain't got time to stop and take no nap. Yeah, that's kind of my concern with just, how slow they've been to release, states and everything. Just, that's my biggest concern. So I go back to an interview I read, I think it was either late 2015 or sometime last year, but, I think it was over. I'll have to look and I'll tweet it out there on Twitter if I find it. But I think it was from, I want to say Rock, Paper, Shotgun, maybe. And they were asked, how long they plan on supporting, ATS. And I thought they said, what was it? Like, maybe about a 4 or 5 year cycle that they were going to support the game. Holy mother of lag. Not sure what's going on with that. Okay, that's fun. But they said they wanted to support the game for about, I want to say it was 4 or 5 years, but at that rate, they'd have to release, what was it, like 12 states a year? Something like that to be able to have all, 48 states. Because I doubt, obviously they're not going to do, Alaska. Probably won't do, Hawaii, because how the heck are you going to get over there? Oh yeah, if they do Texas, it'll be huge. It'll be huge. Imagine Texas is probably taking quite a while, though. Because it's going to be just about as big as the map is now. Pretty daggone close. Now, Texas is going to be an interesting one, though, to see how much they put into it. Really curious about that. If it's just going to be, a handful of cities like we have in most of the states, or they're going to have to add quite a few cities. Really curious to see what they do with that one. At the rate they're going, it'll probably take right about 3 years to get Texas done. That's just going to be the eastern half. With as much as they've expanded, as much as they've expanded over the last year, they almost tripled the size of their team for ATS. Hopefully we can really start to get some stuff, they can get some stuff cranked out this year. Like we've talked in the past, a lot of people feel that they've got the standard set moving forward. Now it's just a matter of, getting the work out there and everything to the people. Come on, FedEx. Thank you. Yes, Publix, I'm in your lane. You might want to stop. Go. I'm going to be that guy and do that thing. There we go.